Hey everyone, welcome to this really exciting episode because Moonshot.ai have just released their latest model, Kimi K2-Thinking. If you look at some of the benchmarks, you can see that it outperforms GPT-5, Claude on it on several different tasks. That said, while I think benchmarks are useful, it's way more important to get practical and actually start building things with these kind of new models. So in today's video, I will be showing you how to get Kimi K2-Thinking running with Claude Code. I then use Claude Code with this model to build an entire web-based Minecraft clone called KimiKraft. And as you can see, it is fully 3D. I can place blocks in the world, I can move around, and it's all running in the browser. And I did not write a single line of code. The other app that I will show you is a full web-based operating system. So as you can see here, I have a finder, I have a calculator, I can do math and it actually works. I have a text editor, a photos viewer, a web browser, as well as do things like turning on and off dark mode. So stick around till the end because I will be giving you the full set of prompts that will allow you to build the exact same apps that you see here today. If you're interested of getting hold of more than just prompts, you might want to check out BuildPack.ai. This is my all-in-one toolkit if you want to level up and get started with building with AI. It includes every single builder pack that I've released up until now, as well as lifetime updates going into the future. You will also get early access to a private Discord community that I'm launching. And to celebrate the launch of Kimi K2-Thinking, I'll be giving away $10 worth of Moonshot API credits to the first 50 people who purchase the all-in-one builder pack. So there's a lot that we'll be covering in today's episode that get you up and running using the Kimi K2-Thinking model in your apps today so that you can see what all the hype is about. Are you ready? Let's get started. All right, so the very first step is to just get this working with Claude Code. Open up your favorite editor. It could be Cursor, it could be VS Code. Open up the terminal. What you want to do is just open up the ZSHRC, but if you are on Windows, it's probably going to be the BashRC instead, okay? Once you've opened this up, you probably have a bunch of things that already might be in there. And so what you want to do is just find some space over here, and then you want to create this new Kimi function. What this does is that it's going to overwrite some of the environment variables, so the Anthropic base URL. So you can see this api.moonshot.ai. You put your token over here, and I'll show you how to get this in just a moment. And then you set both your Anthropic model and your Anthropic fast model to Kimi K2-Thinking. And the way that you get hold of your API key, go to platform.moonshot.ai console. If you haven't created an account, you can just sign in and using Google Auth. Go to API keys. And then you do create API key over here. You can type in some random name here that you want, so Claude Code, and then you will set this to default. And this should give you an API key that you can just paste into here. And the other thing to mention is that if you don't actually have any credits, you will need to top it up. You can use a very small amount, like $10. As I mentioned in the intro to today's video, I'm actually giving away some Moonshot AI credits, thanks to the Moonshot team. So you can check out the links in the description below if you're interested in getting some free credits so that you can play around with this. So this was the token that I had over here. So once this is done, we just have to source the same file again so that it actually refreshes it. Or you can just kill and reopen the terminal. That should be fine. And now all you have to do is just type Kimi. And you will see here that it will show you that it's using Kimi K2-Thinking and API usage billing. So this will be different than if you were running Claude, because if you ran Claude, it will actually show you Sonnet 4.5 and Claude Pro, which is my subscription. So once you have this here, you can use one of these two prompts that I provided. So one is for the Minecraft clone and the other one is for the Kimi Web OS. And you can just copy and paste these prompts and throw them in. Now, before I go ahead and build these apps, I think it's really quite important to understand what makes Kimi K2-Thinking so different from the other models from the other providers, as well as the previous Kimi K2 model that they released about 3 months ago. Now, the two big differences in this new model is that, number one, it can execute up to 200 to 300 sequential tool calls without human interference, which makes it really good for agentic tasks. The second thing is that it has something called interleaved reasoning and tools. Rather than just thinking once and then giving a response, it will actually do multiple reasoning steps before finally giving the user the result. And that's the reason why it does exceptionally well with agentic reasoning and agentic search tasks. When it comes to coding, however, you can see that there are some mixed results over here. And there are several reasons for that. But the thing to highlight here is, number one, the Kimi K2 model is a lot cheaper than GPT-5 and Anthropic's models. And the second thing is that it is completely open weights. So you can actually host this model on your own hardware yourself and run it completely free. And to have such a state-of-the-art model available for free that you can self-off is just amazing. All right, so I'm going to show you the two demo applications that I built. First of all, I'm going to do Kimi. They followed the instructions before. You can see Kimi K2-Thinking. And this is actually the first application that we'll be looking at, which is a full operating system simulated a little bit like what with macOS. All right, so you can see here that there's this dock over here with the nice magnification effects. It has like Finder, desktop, documents, and the trash. All right, so in terms of functionality that it already has, you can see if I open up Finder, it has this simulated Finder environment. Okay, if I go to this browser, I can actually create new tabs, and then you can do something like HTTPS, and then I can do, say, github.com. And you can see there's this mock page. I'm actually pretty sure that it would maybe be able to actually embed an actual web page over here. But anyway, but this is obviously just mocked for now. The other thing that it's able to do is that it has a full-blown calculator. So you can see we can do 12 plus 12 equals to 24. All right, great. And then it has a text editor that also works. And you see that one of the issues that I had. So I actually did this in one prompt. And the prompt that I use is actually available here. So you can see it goes KimiOS Enhance. And you can see it's over here. It's just about just under 200 lines. And the only additional prompt I had to do after that was that in some cases, the text was black on a dark background. So you can see this also happening over here. But otherwise, it actually works pretty well. And I'm sure you can actually just prompt your way to fixing these small issues. Let's see. So if you go to terminal, there's a thick terminal over here. And I wonder where the LS works. Yeah, you can see, right? You can do LS, you can do downloads, you can do music, you can go to downloads, right? You can go to music. This actually looks like it's actually a real terminal. And then there's this fake photo gallery that you have over here. So you can see forest paths, skyscrapers, and I'm pretty sure if you can ask it to connect to something like Unsplash, this would actually look a lot better. And you can see there's actually categorization that's happening over here. So like the tagging system, and then there's this music player, but there's no music that's actually playing at the moment. So that's where you managed to get to. So it's actually pretty decent, right? All of these functionality that you see over here, like I mentioned, there are a few bugs, as you can see with the text colors, but it has this nice frosted effect that you can see in the windows. They're all fully resizable. You can actually drag and drop them around. It has a dark mode as well. And a couple of things that aren't working, as you can see over here, is if you go to Finder and then you actually try to click these, this is not working. So this didn't manage to work, but overall, you can see that this is actually really good for a single shot attempt. And I'm very impressed with how it's managed to get to this point. I got to give credit to Jason Zero because he was the one who actually showed this prompt here, which actually created this very similar kind of web OS. And this one's actually working even better because it actually has a Wikipedia loading in the background, and it actually has the paint app as well that actually works. I think you can go ahead and modify the prompt and ask it for more functionality, and you'll probably be able to get quite similar results. His prompt was a lot shorter. You should definitely check out his channel. He has a lot of really great material and tips and tricks on using things like Claude Code. This is our version of it, and this is the prompt that I use over here. So the way you do it is like literally just copy and paste this, and I'm just going to show this to you right over here. So I'm just going to expand this, and all you have to do is just copy the prompt, and then in this case, I'll say put this in a new subfolder called KimiOS V2. And then you can see the thinking traces are actually starting. So this is fully compatible with Claude Code. In the past, I've had issues whenever I use something like OpenRouter. I think they fixed that issue now. If you leave this to run, it will come up with a plan. And just as I said it, you can see this is the to-dos. If you do Control O now, you can see the thinking, right? So let me break this incredibly detailed complex request. Must be to build a complete browser-based operating system. And then you can see that says reasoning. And then it says, I'll build a complete browser-based operating system. And then you can see it does its thinking again, right? So I created a comprehensive to-do list. So this is Kimi K2-Thinking working fully within Claude Code. And once you let this run, you will see that you will end up with something similar to mine. If you have any suggestions on how to adjust the prompt, make it shorter, make it come up with something that's much better, I'm very happy. Please let me know in the comments. All right, so that's the Kimi OS that you've seen over here. So let's take a look at our second application. All right, so this is the second application that is built here. So you can see this is what I call KimiKraft. It's a Minecraft clone. It's all in a single file. And this one, I didn't manage to one-shot it, even though it got quite far. So the first thing I encountered was that there was like a rendering error whereby everything was just black on screen. For some reason, blocks were rendering. But then that was actually pretty easy to fix. I just prompted it to fix the renderer. As you can see, it's got some very basic mechanics here. So I can place the blocks here. With the right mouse click button, I can run and I can jump. And oh yeah, and I had to fix something to do with the mouse locking, because for some reason when I was scrolling left and right, after a while, the as opposed to like keeping the yaw the only axis to be changed, it was affecting the other axis as well. So, you know, it did really well considering that I just started off with a single prompt. And it got to this stage where it just generated this procedural generated terrain. It looks really good. And there's some functionality that's still missing, which I'm pretty sure you can just go ahead and prompt it to be able to, you can just prompt it to be able to fix it. For example, I would love to have a crosshair. And the other thing is that I think the breaking of the cubes isn't quite working yet. And the last thing to mention is that it would be good for the player to be able to automatically climb the steps. This was my initial prompt that I tried. So quite short, less than 15 lines. But then what I then did was that after I saw some of the bugs, I actually told it to enhance the prompt. And so this is the enhanced prompt. It's a little bit longer, but then it avoids some of the errors that it saw with the rendering as well. And you can see the analysis that it did in order to fix these problems. So one thing that you will see is that Kimi K2-Thinking is actually really good with things like writing. I think when it comes to things like improving prompts or anything to do with creative writing or improving the writing, I think this is probably where it shines really well. If you actually look at some of the examples on the Kimi K2 website, comparing the thinking models versus the non-thinking models, the results are actually really good when it comes to like fiction writing or writing things in a certain style. And I think this is one of the areas where Kimi K2 can really shine. So improving the prompts that you have. And that's the reason why we are able to have this enhanced prompt. So we copy and paste this into Claude Code, just like what we did, and say, build this in subfolder KimiKraft V2, just so that it doesn't clobber what I already have running. You will see the same thing happening here. So it goes through the thinking, and then it should be able to, ideally, one shot as close to what on screen here. Like I said, it's not perfect. And as mentioned very early on in the video, there are some stronger coding models, but I think where you can see Kimi K2-Thinking really coming into play, in addition to it being able to improve prompts, creative writing, and at least get you to this point, is that don't forget, like it is cheaper, you can self-host it. And if you're like me, I've actually downgraded from Max to Pro now, and I do hit my rate limits every so often, but then it's hard to justify that big jump from, I think, like $15 all the way up to $75, or I can't remember the prices anymore. And Kimi K2 is actually a really good interim solution. I think even if you have $10, $20 of Kimi K2 credits, it should be able to tide you through the month. And that's much cheaper, and it gives you pretty good results as well. So I've been playing around quite a lot with Kimi K2. So you can see here, I can't remember exactly how much I started off with. I think it was maybe $54. So I've used less than $10, and I've been using it a lot. If you actually take a look here, you can actually see I've been playing around with like different apps, like a debate arena, a dashboard app. I actually created multiple different applications, a comparison website, a world simulation as well. And I actually am working on creating some Claude Code skills that will allow you to use the API a lot better. So all of this, I think I haven't even touched $10, and I've been using it quite a lot. I can see no real need to upgrade my plan back to Max. If I ever run off quota and have to wait a couple of hours, I'll just use Kimi K2-Thinking. So just jumping in here, you can actually see what's going on here. So it says it's thinking about creating a Minecraft-like game using the core technologies. And then, like I said, you will see here, it will actually do a second round of thinking because it knows that it needs to create a project structure. And this will continue on until the end of the implementation. I would love to know if you have any suggestions of how I could have improved the prompt to get more features maybe, and maybe some of the missing functionality included. So that brings us to the end of this video. I really hope you found this useful. I think this is a really great model, and the fact that it just plays so nicely with Claude Code out of the box with hardly any configuration is just really good. And not forgetting, this is open weights, it is cheap, and you can actually self-host this. I think Moonshot have really knocked it out of the park with this one. So if you liked today's video, don't forget to give it a like, hit that subscribe button, and turn on notifications so that you're always the first to know whenever new content like this drops. I think there's a lot more things that's going to come out with Kimi K2-Thinking. Once Groq gets hold of this Kimi K2-Thinking model, which I believe is happening very soon based on what I've seen on Twitter, this model will become extremely fast as well. At that point, it will almost be a no-brainer to be utilizing it. If you saw my previous video, which I did, I actually showed you how you actually can connect Claude Code to many other different models. So anyway, hope you enjoyed this episode. Keep building, and I'll see you next time.